Aircraft is made at the company's Downsview facility. Well, now to our exclusive series this week on cell phone tower emissions and how they might be affecting people's health. Both Ottawa and the industry say the emissions are safe, but some people claim the signals are making them sick. In the third and last installment in our series, Stephanie Matisse shows you a man who claims he's got some solutions.
Now we're reading approximately 150 microwatts.
Robert Metzinger is measuring the electromagnetic signal coming from this cell phone tower. He's using a handheld radiation detector. Now, it may sound like the meter is going crazy, but the levels are actually well below the maximum Canadian standards for exposure. Though that doesn't put everyone's mind at ease, some are still worried about the health effects of these signals. In extremely rare cases, some people have a sensitivity to them. And that gave Metzinger his business idea.
Some of the products are a shielding fabric that has a metallic thread woven into it, which reflects RF radiation. Also, we have window foil paint, and we have bed shielding canopies, which people sleep under.
He demonstrates one of his products by reading the signal from this cell phone and then blocking it with this fabric shield. He also sells this cell phone headset. It's different than most. It has an air tube, which is kind of like a stethoscope. Metzinger says that it can keep electromagnetic signals away from your brain. It costs about $45. There are lots of products out there that claim to protect people from radiation. This is just a sampling of the ones available online. Everything from special ceramics to cell phone chips, and they range from $5 to $1,000. Michelle Ilyatovich doesn't have all those bells and whistles in her home. She started small and put filters on the outlets because of her daughter.
She was diagnosed with chronic fatigue syndrome. She was a kid, she wanted to do things, but she literally couldn't get out of bed.
She says her daughter has more energy and her family swears by the filters. They're different from Metzinger's products, but this physicist says they all amount to the same thing.
These sorts of products are, they're business responses to an entrepreneurial opportunity, and they will go and make money off people's fears. P.T. Barnum, you know, there's a sucker born every minute.
Tony Moots has dedicated his life to studying electromagnetic frequencies and was even on the World Health Organization's EMF committee. He's seen health concerns ebb and flow as new technology comes out, like microwave ovens, computers, and now wireless phones. So far, the bottom line has been the same.
To claim that there's scientific evidence that indicates it's a health hazard, I think is deplorable.
Now, he also says that science never concludes, so expect more studies on this and more controversy, Diana.
It's been a really interesting series, Steph, and I'm wondering what kind of feedback you've been getting since we started running this.
We've been hearing from viewers from Simcoe, as you might imagine, and Toronto, Vancouver, and even as far as Boston. And a lot of them, just to reinforce that element of controversy, have been sending their own research, things that they've dug up. Now, just as an example, the mayor of Simcoe sent me this study that was published at the end of July, and it says there are no adverse health effects related to cell phone towers. And another viewer sent me this one that's from today, and it says that you can't rule out long-term effects. So again, this story will be ongoing.
Yeah, it really shows the depth of the debate. Thanks, Steph. Well.